failure. They will now win the battle. But when a basketball player works with the team members, works with his sensor, works with his point guard, his shooting guard, his whatever guard, ladies and gentlemen, they win the basketball game.
Amen.
That's how it is when walking with Jesus Christ. When you come with the body of believers, because we are all body, we win the spiritual warfare. Amen? We're not, no man and no woman is an island. We're not islands. Amen? We're called to have other believers to speak a word into our life, to help us out in this walk. I know in my walk, ladies and gentlemen, sometimes my brother Sean will tell me something in my life that I'm doing wrong, and I need that rebuke. I need that correction, because it's enabling me to make the right choice. Ladies and gentlemen, we need it as well. Y'all need it as well. We all need rebukes and corrections to help us in this world, because we do not know it all. No, none of us know it all. It's important to study, yes. It's important to learn the Word of God as much as possible, but at the end of the day, there's always something we can learn from somebody else. Hallelujah, glory be to God. Thank you, Lord. And I also want to tell y'all this. To anybody out there that's putting up a fight against God, don't put up a fight against God. You will lose. Hear me when I tell you this. Anyone who fight against Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior, you will lose. He is the everlasting God. He is the eternal Father, and he can step in and work it together for your good.
Amen.
If you read throughout the Old Testament, God took out people like the Jebusites, the Gergesites, the Amalekites, the Hivites, all these rights, ladies and gentlemen, he took them out with his help. Amen. When the children of Israel, when the book of Joshua, when they saw the giants, ladies and gentlemen, they were afraid. Oh yeah, they were nervous. But Joshua and Caleb was like, "He's mightier than these giants. We're gonna take him out. Let's go." And that's how God wants us to be. He wants us to come in full charge with God's help and watch him bring the victory. Yes, he will. Sometimes, ladies and gentlemen, I don't even know what to say. I stand here, I share the good news of Jesus, and I'm out of words. But when God's Holy Spirit comes on, he brings the victory.
Come on,
amen? Because I'm on the winning side. And he's looking for somebody out there to be on the winning side as well. But you got to make the choice tonight, right now. Don't wait till Sunday.
Amen.
Don't wait till next week. Make that choice right now, my brothers and sisters, because that train ride may be the very last train ride you may be on. You never know. Receive Jesus today. He loves you, New York. He loves you, Harlem. He loves you, Bronx. It doesn't matter where you are. It doesn't matter what your block say. Your block will tell you, "Oh, you soft for following Jesus. Oh, you a punk. You a coward." No. What the block said don't mean nothing. It's about what God says.
Amen.
Hallelujah. The Bible says in Romans chapter 8, verse 28, "For we know everything work together for the good. For those who love God and those who are called and called into his purpose." The Bible says in Philippians chapter 4, verse 12, "That I can do all things through Christ who gives me strength." Hallelujah. Amen. You can do all things through Christ who gives you strength. The Bible says in John chapter 14 that whoever believes in Jesus, they will do even greater works than what he has done. Hallelujah. Greater works. And it's available, ladies and gentlemen. But first and foremost, in order to win the battle, you got to have ammunition. Here we go. Whenever a soldier, come on now, whenever a soldier is getting ready to go out into the land,
come on now,
to conquer the land,
yes,
to win the land, amen? They don't think about their lives.
Amen.
They don't think about what's going to happen to them. The commander-in-chief has said, you have to go out there, obey the commands from the commander-in-chief, and go out there and conquer the land. But ladies and gentlemen, before the soldier goes out to conquer the land, they have to go through training.
Come on now.
They have to go through running through the mud.
Yes.
They have to go through, you know, going through the woods, getting bitten by ticks and mosquitoes. They have to go through the water, holding their breath underwater for like 10 minutes.
Come on now.
You know, you can't breathe. They have to go through the training before they can step out into the battlefield.
Yes.
And that's how it is when walking with God.
I want to hear nothing about somebody saying, oh, I'm a Christian, and you have not been through the battle. You have not seeking God's face. You have not been reading your Bible. You have not fasting, denying your flesh, getting closer to God. You're not ready for the battle. No, you're not. God needs us to kill this flesh in order to be prepared for the battle, because there's demons out there. There's an enemy called the devil who wants to take out God's children.
Yes.
Amen. We have to be prepared.
Amen.
We have to be with our armor. We have to be with our full armor on. And
amen.
Ephesians chapter 6, it talks about the helmet, the breastplate, the feet, the sword, the shield.
Amen.
We need to have the full armor of God. Amen.
Oh, no.
The
yes.
full armor of God. You can't just have the helmet and you don't have your sword and your shield. You're gonna look embarrassed. You're looking embarrassing.
Amen.
God's gonna be like, you're not ready. Amen.
Yes.
As a matter of fact, Jesus gave a parable about a specific group of people that he wanted to gather into his banquet, a specific people.
Uh-huh.
And there was one person who didn't have a garment on. And the king went to the person and said, how did you get in here without a garment? Throw him out. Ladies and gentlemen, if you don't got the robe of righteousness on you, you're not going to see the kingdom of heaven. Amen. Jesus said in Matthew chapter 5, unless your righteousness exceeds the righteousness of the Pharisees,
come on,
you're
now,
not,
you
not
going to
see
this.
The kingdom of heaven. I'm coming from the royal point of view.
Amen.
I'm not coming from my point of view.
That's
I'm coming from the biblical point of view.
Come on now,
amen?
Preach.
You got to get the word in you in order to be prepared for battle. But
amen.
I want to say this. It's not based on our righteousness. It's based on his righteousness, because no one is righteous, not even one. According
no.
to Romans chapter 3, verse 21. None of us are righteous. It's only through the righteousness of God that we are righteous, my brothers and sisters. So receive him today. Receive him today. To those who have not seen him, who's crying, my message is clear. God is called all men and women everywhere to repent. If you don't know the definition of repent means, amen, it means to change. It means to change. Yes? God wants you to change internally. You don't have to change externally. If you want to look the way you look, hey, but internally, God wants to do construction in your heart. You know, I met some people throughout my time, and they see me as a Christian now. And when they see the light on me, they're very prideful, and they say, yo, bro, I ain't changing for nobody. This is who I am. You know what that is, ladies and gentlemen? That's pride. That's what it is. Because God has to give into that pride. He has to break that pride in order for that individual to humble themselves and recognize who he is. Don't get it twisted. God cannot use people who are prideful. No. Jesus said that whoever humbles himself will be exhausted, and whoever exalts themselves will be abased. They will be put low. Oh yeah, it's going to happen. It is very important to always humble ourselves in the sight of God. To not think that we have it all together. To not think that we are better than God, because we're not. That's why in 2 Corinthians chapter 12, the Apostle Paul talks about a thorn in his flesh. And to this day, there's a huge debate on what was the thorn that was on the flesh of the Apostle Paul. It's a huge debate. But there was a reason why God placed a thorn on the Apostle Paul. Because the Apostle Paul was getting so many revelations from God. And so the Apostle Paul prayed 3 times. He said, Lord, remove this from me. And God told the Apostle Paul, he said, my grace is sufficient in weakness. Amen? Sometimes you have to go through the trials. It doesn't feel good, but God has to put a spiritual thorn in your life to keep you humble, ladies and gentlemen. It doesn't hurt. Ladies and gentlemen, I've had seasons in my life when I had thorns that you wouldn't believe. Oh, like, God, can you remove this?
Mm-hmm.
But God was like, no, Tim, I need to keep this on you because my grace is sufficient. Amen? And that's why the Apostle Paul goes on to say, therefore I rejoice in my weaknesses, in my distress, in my persecutions. Because when I am weak, then I am made strong. There's
Preach.
A reason why we have to go through the thorn in our side like the Apostle Paul.
Amen.
It's going to make us stronger. And if anyone has seen gold before, whenever you put gold in the fire, it has to be refined. Amen? We are like spiritual gold, ladies and gentlemen, and God has to put us through the fire. But when you come out the fire, you're going to be more firm and more refined. Yes. nor refined. So don't get discouraged when God puts you through your spiritual fire, ladies and gentlemen. To those who are about to get on the call once again, my message is clear. God is calling all men and women everywhere to repent. Yes, remember that word. To repent. To have a turn away. Amen? From your ways, from our ways. Amen? Not only from sin, but from everything of this world, and to live for God, ladies and gentlemen. To repent. Hallelujah. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but will have everlasting life. For God did not send his Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world might be saved through him. It's your choice, ladies and gentlemen. I can't force anybody out there. I'm just a messenger. All right? I'm not.